Tyler Lockett's phenomenal play on the field can only be outshined by the phenomenal work he's doing in the community. What's going on? Jackie Montgomery with your Seahawks Daily. Well, wide receiver Tyler Lockett leads the team with 881 receiving yards, and he is on pace for his third consecutive 1,000-plus yard season. It's the work that he's done on the field the last 7 years that has put his name all over the Seahawks record book, but it's the work that he's done in the community that has earned him the title Seahawks Walter Payton Man of the Year.
Honestly, man, just to be nominated as the Walter Payton Man of the Year Award, it really means a lot. I'm somebody that doesn't like to tell people, you know, a lot of stuff that I do off the field. And so it was kind of weird for me because when I was nominated, then everybody's hearing about all the stuff that I do off the field. And sometimes you just get caught up and you don't want people to know because then it makes you feel like you're doing it for everybody to see. But for me, it was just a recognition that I really take the heart and something that I appreciate because I seen like other people when I got here. You know, I seen what Russ does. I seen what Bobby does. I seen a whole group of people, Michael Bennett, Cliff Averill, even our general manager, John Snyder. Like you see the stuff that people do off the field and the difference that they want to make for whatever it is that they believe in. And for me, I wanted to be able to do that same thing. And there's a lot of things that I want to be able to do, but I understood that even the work that I want to do off the field is also a marathon, just like the football season. It's a marathon. It's never a sprint. And so I wanted to be able to focus on certain things so that way when I'm done playing, I can continue to do those same things. And it's not just something that started and then it finishes when I'm done.
Last year, Lockett, the two-time Pro Bowler and former first-team All-Pro return specialist, set the Seahawks franchise record with 100 receptions. He ranks fourth in Seahawks history in receiving touchdowns, fifth in receiving yards, and sixth in catches.
He's been a marvelous pro. I mean, just, I say that because of his consistency, and consistency at such a high level. I mean, he's never not been at a top level of play. Not always recognized for it, for whatever reason, although I think in the last couple of years, his numbers continue to be so crazy positive that everybody's aware of him, and he continues to make huge plays happen in the game, and then he makes difficult plays look routine. I mean, the catch he makes on the sidelines in front of the bench was like his perfect to catch, like the one he had against the Rams in the corner of the end zone. So it's as perfect of body control and timing and feel and all that as you can make. So he makes the plays that support the guy as a leader on your team. I do call on him quite a bit. He does more than you think. I mean, he's kind of soft-spoken and all that, but he has a lot to say. He's got a great sense for what's going on, and he's been here through a lot of stuff, and he has a real voice.
Very deserving. Lockett is just one of the best people I've ever met. You know what I mean? And to have someone like him in our locker room, I think it's helped us tremendously. Obviously, people see the kind of player he is, but the conversations that you have with him, seeing the work he does in the community, he's all about positivity. The message he sends is nonstop positivity and just giving you different insights on how to view life in certain situations. He actually gave us a message before last week's game, the Saturday night, I think that really opened a lot of guys' eyes and really helped us in our efforts on Sunday. So I'm very, very happy for him, and he's definitely deserving of it.
Whether it's helping galvanize the team with a speech or inspiring youth through spoken word or his work as a published author, Lockett is focused on empowering others to reach their full potential. Through his Light It Up Foundation, Lockett has given back to the community in a myriad of ways, including football camps, job shadow programs, funding scholarships, and financial contributions to organizations both in Seattle and his hometown of Tulsa, Oklahoma.
When I think about a guy like Tyler Lockett, he's a man that demonstrates, everything that's good. He's a guy who's obviously a really amazing teammate to everyone. He works his butt off every day. He loves the game. But I think what's amazing about Tyler is he uses his gifts to serve others, and he uses his gifts to love others and impact others in such a tremendous way. And we couldn't have a better man of the year than Tyler Lockett and what he's demonstrated for this football team. Demonstrated for this organization, demonstrated what's good, about the city, and and he's done so many amazing things.
For me, it's about figuring out what is my role, like what is my part in this game of life, or what is my part on this team, and that's kind of the things that always keep me going because I know that each week things can change. One day the fantasy people love me. The next day they're mad I didn't get any targets, you know. But at the end of the day, am I doing my part to be able to help my team win? And that's the same thing within my community. It's like, am I doing enough to be able to help my community win? But the question is, am I happy with what I'm doing? And am I doing enough? If the people that I have in my circle, that those safe places, are they looking at it like you're doing more than anything that you should be doing at this point in your life right now? So those are the things that, for me, I kind of focus on, being able to have ideas that will make a generational change, you know, something that'll continue to change for 10, 20, 30 years. But it's just being able to do my part. I can't save my city, but I can be able to make it better than what it was when I came into that city.
Well, as the Seahawks Man of the Year nominee, Tyler Lockett is receiving up to $40,000 for the charity of his choice. If he wins the NFL's Walter Payton Man of the Year award, he could win up to $250,000 for the charity of his choice. But in the meantime, you can help him win an additional $25,000 through the charity challenge. Head over to Seahawks Twitter for more information on the social media campaign. Voting runs through January 17th.